The Iridium Catalysed Electrolysis CubeSat Thruster, ICE Cube Thruster, is a micro-scale rocket engine which is being developed at Imperial College London under ESA's General Support Technology Program. The thruster utilizes the propellants of hydrogen and oxygen produced by the electrolysis of water and is designed to produce a thrust of only 4.5 millinewtons. Designing a thruster to function at this scale is a unique challenge and requires a very different approach compared to the typical rocket engines most people are accustomed to. To put it into perspective, the space shuttle main engine has approximately 500 million times more thrust than ICE cube. The reason for such a small-scale thruster is to meet the needs of the rapidly growing small satellite market. The annual number of spacecraft deployed in 2020 is over 3 times the number in 2016. Of this growing market, nanosats, less than 10 kilograms, constitute the vast majority of spacecraft launched, approximately 90% in 2017. These tiny satellites, usually the size of a briefcase, have very strict constraints which make integrating a propulsion system difficult. A propulsion system is required to be very small, operate on very low power, and in most cases use unpressurized non-toxic propellants. The ICE cube thruster meets these requirements by using an electrolyzer to split water into its constituent molecules of hydrogen and oxygen in space and feed these directly to the thruster. The immediately obvious benefits of the system are primarily the ease of storage of a non-hazardous propellant in compact lightweight tanks, as well as the very favorable performance of hydrogen oxygen. Water electrolysis also requires only a fraction of the power of comparable electric propulsion devices, which is well within the power range available for nanosatellites. Fabricating such a tiny thruster is not feasible using conventional manufacturing techniques. The combustion chamber and nozzle are less than 1 mm in length and can only be achieved using a MEMS, microelectrical mechanical systems approach. This is the same fabrication approach used to manufacture microelectronics such as processors, and it allows silicon wafers to be machined with sub-micrometer precision. The approach is also inherently scalable and allows thrusters to be produced in large batches at an exceptionally low unit cost.